Hey, Don here. Okay, back with another live stream. And I saw it. The last one was November 4th. So, and this is December the 9th. So, now I forgot what it was on, but this is going to be on. I've got a box over here. I ordered me a. Well, I'll just let you see that here in a minute. And let's see. Okay, let's just get over to the box and we'll open it up, and then I'm going to get it out, you know, hook it up, test it, whatever. I'm going to switch to the right mic so I can get
up. Okay, now. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and use that same camera. And I'm going to make sure mics still that my audio works. Okay, I had to make sure that, you know, we're getting the audio up to YouTube. I'm getting the, since I'm already here at it, I'm getting the page I want to have up. There we go, but I won't go to it just yet. Okay, now, I am free from the SM58 right now. I don't like being free from it, but because I like sounds so much better. It is a little more tricky to keep it working, right? Because, you know, you got to stay the right distance, and the old V-Amp, too, it's getting old, and I think that it's just not... The effects aren't made, you know, or the unit itself probably just not quite as working quite as well as it used to. But I haven't got anything else yet, so it's still working fine. Okay, so I gotta get my little knife out. Oh yeah, I gotta get my little knife out, but first I gotta put the camera on what I'm gonna be doing here. So Oops, it might not have to go up in the air. I thought I was going to have to raise it up in the air, but it really doesn't need it. That's just fine and dandy. Never mind all the junk I had to set on the bed. All that stuff was on the table. I couldn't use it. All right, so here we go. A little box from Amazon. I've had this thing for about a week, I think, and I didn't want to... open it until I got on the video, and because see how it arrived. I don't think it got completely crushed or anything, so I don't think what's inside is going to be messed up, but you don't know until you get in there and find out. It's getting dull. One more. Worked pretty good that time. I think the end of it's just getting dull. So. Ta-da! My favorite coffee. Oh, that's not really worthy of a video, is it? That just happened to be ordered at the same time. Somebody shot me. Those aren't as fun as they used to be, but I still do it once in a while. I'll get a whole long string of them and keep popping them. Oh, dang. Can you believe that? Yeah, somebody must have thrown that thing about 150 feet. How the heck would that happen? Unless it was thrown. The box isn't crushed and it ain't got no footprints on it, so it wasn't not completely crushed. But you know, that's what would happen if it was thrown. I took it out already, but I believe it was sitting like that. It was thrown, and then that's from the impact. Now, there's no excuse for that. That didn't have that. Well, it could have happened anywhere. I was thinking, say it didn't happen in the factory, you know, where they're putting it together in the Amazon warehouse, but it very well could have. As a matter of fact, is from what I've heard of how hard they work. How this time of year, Christmas, you know, working people were trying to work fast, got a little over exuberant there. So we're gonna make sure this brand new freaking $200 hard drive, and that was on a good sale, isn't hurt. It's a 14 terabyte Western Digital. My other two, I've got a 5 and an 8, and they're Seagates. And used to, however many years ago I bought the last one, Western Digitals were always higher, but this year they're the only ones that was given any prices that I was even interested in at all, you know. There is, well, with the hard drives, let's just look at it first. They had overall worse reviews, but I don't think there's really that much difference in the two brands. Okay. Let's just keep it on the table so that it will be in the picture. Got the plastic all around it. I was pulling it up towards me to see if it looked like it had been hit. Okay. Everything looks good. I guess there was enough shock zone in there for... That's just inexcusable the way that's damaged, though. The way that, expensive electronics get thrown around like that. I've seen a couple over the years that were, and here's the power supply and the papers and stuff, that were obviously stepped on, you know, the big old dirty footprint on them, but a couple of boxes, I mean, not hard drives. But that is the Elements 14 terabyte. And, got a little book, got some more plastic. Let's put the more plastic back in the box. Now if it was messed up enough that it wouldn't, something wouldn't work, then, I'm sure I still have time to send it back, but. Because you get more than a week, but I couldn't believe I never did get it done. I just wasn't feeling good. I just every day that I thought about it, I thought about doing it every day, but didn't feel good enough to do it. But anyway, and I wanted to make the video. I really just wanted to make the video anyway. But after I saw that box like that, I thought I better not even open the box until I'm ready to make the video. Give me some scissors to open that. I don't want to tear up the packing too much in case there was a need to send it back. But I always do that. Yeah, you can't get that to open. Okay. And that's something here that was kind of surprising to me. I'll show it more under the endoscope maybe in a minute, but I don't know if you'll be able to tell it in this camera. It's not good at close-ups at all. But the plug that goes into the hard drive itself, it looks just like the Seagate. I thought that was a, you know, proprietary Seagate design, but Western Digital's using one very similar. I mean, I haven't looked at them side by side. But, I'll just leave that there. Get over here and get on endoscope. I've got it over here on my, where I can put it on my keyboard tray. Set stuff on my keyboard tray and I can turn on the endoscope. Now, I guess I'll just turn this back. See my boxes of stuff. I'm pretty well just all stocked up. No more room for no more new toys. That's not all what that is, but a lot of it, a bunch of that used to be in the top of the closet. Well, I don't know. There's more boxes over there. I got them down to put a vent in the closet for my server, my DL. That's what this is going to be plugged into, my DL380 G7 server. HP brand. Oh, I need something. It doesn't look so... Last time I got an envelope and used that, but that's way over there. Let's see if I can do it like this. I don't know what it'll look like till I get on it, but so we'll just get on it. Okay, we'll get on the endoscope. That'll do well enough. Last time I used a white envelope, but I wanted to look at this anyway. There we go. Let's see. It's not straight to me, but it's getting straight to the camera. That's what's important. Oops, got to get on an angle of the light. Asian Power Devices, Inc. Uh-huh, APD. Okay, AC adapter. China's talk. WB18R12. Foo. F-U. Ha! All right. Input, 100 to 220 volt AC. 50, 60 hertz. 0.6 amp maximum input. Okay, now output, 120 volts. 12 volts. I thought something. 12.0 volt. Can you hear that jet plane? You might not. They don't. My mics are pretty good. They don't pick up everything because of the the natural process. The processing that came with the phone I'm using. I'm running these lapels through a phone over the Wi-Fi to the computer. There's a delay, but it works. And my SM58, I have a noise gate and a compressor in that VAMP I was talking about a while ago. That's what kind of ends up making some noise sometimes. Anyway. Output 12 volts, okay, 1.5 amp, 18 watt, sure is, 18 watts, okay. Oh, and the center is positive and the outer ring is negative on the connector. These are things you might need to know sometimes on these things, like if one breaks and you need to fix it. So the center would be positive and the sleeve would be, so that's, this is a tip ring connector. And well, it's a female female tip ring connector. So, and then there's a little bit more stuff on the bottom. I just wanted to know that much because I can't, it'd take a, I got my magnifying glasses, but I wouldn't be able to read it with them very well. So since this is already on. So here's the regular connector that you'd plug, the USB that you'd plug into your computer. And here is the I was thinking was a proprietary for Seagate, but they look similar. I mean, I bet it's not exactly the same. If this were plugged into a Seagate USB, I'd be surprised. I have one up there that's not on. I might try that in a minute. All right. And then, it's heavy. The only thing worth, looks scratchy even though it had the plastic on it. Yeah, now you can see the light. I finally did this. I've thought about it, I don't know how many times. I used to have the endoscope on a tripod, but it was very hard to adjust with it on this light on an arm with springs, you know. And I can just do that, adjust it any way I want to. Oops, too far. So, my little red background's not the only thing you see it anymore, but that's all right. Okay. Of course, DC in, it says 12 volts. I can barely make that out, but that might be a little better for me. A bunch of symbols and dimbles and bimbles. And that says product of... Let's see if I can get in close enough for that to show up. Whoa! Hold on. There we go. Yeah, see, that's what this camera is made for, this endoscope. It's only got one focus, but you can get it closer and further to get it into focus. It doesn't adjust, but you can adjust it by moving it. Parked up Thailand. I'm not going to read the serial number, but... sorry. Been a lot of bad allergies the last few days. More numbers. WD. More numbers. And let's see. Is that Ici Les Malonix FR? Oh, that must be French. Hamilton House, Regent Park, Kingston Road, Letterhead, Kentucky, 22-7PL, UK. Now, why would you have Kentucky and then... I guess 22-7PL is an address in the UK, and the other one was an address... I don't know what's moving. Oh, it's me. I'm moving. I can't hold still. Okay, well, I can't really fix that. I can't fix my shaky hands. Okay, it looks just kind of wavy in the video, but now you can kind of see those numbers up there better, but they're not anything I'm going to worry about. Oh, there's a power button. Cool. My other ones don't have a button like that. You have to just unplug it, unless it was so blended in that it's there and I never saw it. But I'm talking about Seagates now. But it has vents. Just turn it that way. And on the top too, thought maybe the light would let you see down in there a little bit, but not really. So they go all the way around. Only place where there's not vents is this rounded edge. Oh, and there's the WD Elements logo. Shiny. Shiny, shiny plastic. Okay, now I'm going to put my, that was my, I have three mouse pads over here. And down under here, I have this extra, this is just a cheap desk up here, but I built this out of white oak. I had it left from building my bathroom cabinets years ago, back in 2000. Well, it was 01, I think. But anyway, I needed the extra room. Like sometimes I turn on this wireless mouse. And anyway, it gives me something nice to lay. This supports my arm so I don't get fatigued, and then the pads make it feel better. So you needed to know that. You really did. Okay. And you know what's a cool side effect? Well, I mean, it's not a side effect, but with turning on this light so that my endoscope will show things well and all that, it makes this camera here work better. It is sometimes flickering a little. That's what it'll do when it's not a good automatic white balance and you know, can't even think of all the different things, f-stops, you know, all that stuff. It does it, but it's not that good at it. Probably if this was setting a little bit lower or a little bit higher, it wouldn't be so bad. I think it's a little high. It's getting up into the... No, it's still doing it. I call that, a lot of people call that hunting. It's trying to figure out what it should be doing. But anyway, okay, see, like I pushed it further away, and I think it might have helped that. Yeah, it did. Okay, so, but my face looks clear, maybe a little too clear, but it's not grainy. This thing has always been grainy. It's supposed to, it's a 13 megapixel Sony CMOS sensor is what they say they put into this. It's a China 4K camera. Don't you love it when people do that? Anyway, I finally realized that if I give it, I didn't want to try to give it more light in here because my eyes are really sensitive to light. But with that pointing down there, unless I look right where it's shining, like it's shining on my mic, chrome mic stand now, and that's bad. That bothers me. But anyway, it's okay. I can stand it, and I just finally realized I can make the camera look pretty good. Now, it's not over the USB. It can't do the full resolution that it's capable of. It's doing about 3/4 or a little less of the way to its full resolution. I can't remember the numbers. I'm getting over here. I think I will just turn this camera around. It's on a good spot on the tripod, really. I can kind of get to, I never have really needed to get right here, but, well, not much anyway. But what I'm gonna do is get right there. And I think I'll do it that way. That's just my multimeter. I set it up there. Let's see. Yeah, I can check that. I'm gonna move a couple of things, but let's just do that. And oh, I can't either. Okay, so here's the thing I didn't like about that connector. I'm still talking about the connector. Here we are. This thing is in the way. Okay. Don't think I can do any better than that. If I try to zoom in, I think it'll just get too. That's hot glue. The deal. That's one thing I didn't like about it. See how short it is? It's just short. That's how this is my Seagate 5 terabyte drive. I hot glued it on there because if you just sneeze at it, it would disconnect and, break files if anything was being written. This one is NTFS. I left it as it came. It broke that, or once for sure I know I forgot and turned it off. The power to it. Like I said, there's no switch, but I turned the power off to it while it was being written to one time. Other times it could have, maybe that got wiggled or who knows, what all could have happened. But that phone's about to be down on the floor. Okay, now I'll just leave everything as it was until I get done with my video. I said, leave everything alone. I can't. I gotta fix it. All right, go ahead. Okay. No, I wasn't talking to myself. Okay. Oh wow, I should have showed that on the endoscope, but exactly who in the history of the world could ever read something that small? I couldn't read that with any magnifying glass I've got. I'll put it back over there for now. But I'm just gonna plug it in. I guess I should kind of just look at the manual first. So let's do that. Go back to the endoscope for a second. I meant to do that before I got up. I thought I was forgetting something, but I didn't know what it was. Okay, what I'm going to do is plug it into that USB hub I have there, because all of the, it's plugged into the server and all of the, places are occupied. See, that's why I wanted that red thing. It's that key, that keyboard tray is in horrible shape. So, supportwd.com. I don't even know. Which way's, I can kind of tell which way's right side up and which way's upside down. As I say, I don't even know if I can get this where it can be read on here. Okay, yes it can. It can do it. Oh, it can do it pretty well. This is the best $10 I ever spent, I think. That's what all I paid for this camera. It's not any fancy high resolution, but it's now there's one thing, you can't get it all in the deal. If you get the perfect focus, then you may not get all the text that you want in the deal, in the screen. Okay, this is legal junk. I'm gonna open it up and see if I can tell. I guess I'll just open it up and then slide it back under there. These are probably all the different languages, I'm gonna guess. Yep, different language. Different language. Home language, China. Okay, home for this thing. Where it came from. Now, there's looks like some specs. Oh, that's where to get the technical support. So I'm going to look at that right now. Let's see. FCC. Well, it better not be putting out any interference. Okay, this is, I don't think it's a manual. I don't think it's telling you anything. Oh, I just remembered. It's not worth fiddling with. I just remembered I already downloaded the PDF manuals. I can show them on the desktop. That'll be good to do. Okay, let's go to the desktop now. Oops, sorry. I keep forgetting what I should do first. I should have went to the desktop before I started doing that. Now, yeah, I've got it ready to get open here. So, make sure that my sound, I always worry, this Wi-Fi mic does sometimes quit on you when you least expect it. So, I guess I could switch to, let's do it. Anytime I got a chance to not use it, it's a good idea to not use it. Because it does, the audio going over the Wi-Fi is, consumes bandwidth. And sometimes that's what will, make it stop working. The router gets overwhelmed. Sometimes it's something in the phone. Okay, now we're the desktop, we're on the SM58. Okay, now we'll go back. Oh, this is what I paid for it, $199.99. And the coffee. That is good coffee. I've been drinking it for 10, 15 years, I guess. 15 years, probably. Sometimes I get, different years. They may be not as good as others. It may be one first year or two, it was quite a bit stronger. But this year is all I can really remember. It's most of the bags are pretty good, real smooth. It's not bitter like a lot of other coffees are. But anyway, I want that red, yellow fan, red fan. I like the looks of it. No, I need a better vent fan for the closet, for the server. I bought a 3 120 millimeter set, and it's good. I like it, but our air conditioner went out, and I've had to keep it in the window so I can have a fan in here. Okay. Blank. Here it is. Okay, I've got two files. I'm not sure which one. I think this is just the, make sure we're on the, desktop. Oops. Go back to, okay. That's not the right thing either. I don't think my brain wants to work right today. I thought, well, while I'm here, I might as well check. There it is. Check my stream, make sure it's still working. I always load slow. I got 200 megabits down and went to analytics. I wish it would just start out right here at stream health. Okay, it's healthy, excellent. There it is. I don't think my brain was. There we go. I don't like to leave it on there because it will end up overworking the machine. I think I'll just close the browser this time. Keep forgetting and going back to it. I had to take allergy medicine because I was draining so bad and now my throat's dry. But it is beginning to quit draining. Okay. So, here is the. I think this is just kind of the flyer for it. It'll work. It does. It may not work on a USB 1.0. It just says. Well, they usually just say that anyway. But if you look like deeper into the in the specs, it'll say that it does support 1.0. I still use things that are 1.0 sometimes. Have some old computers and stuff that I would maybe want to, back up on here. But anyway, and they have one that's 18 terabyte, but it was like $450, $500. The only one they were marking down was to get, I look at like how much, $1 per terabyte, that's what I look at. That's how I look at it with them. And I don't get down and figure out, with a calculator, I just kind of look at the different
glance, you know, look at the different prices and sizes and see what seems to work. Sometimes I guess I have used the calculator a little bit. But anyway, yeah, this is just a flyer. And now we're getting to the other page. Okay, here's some specs, but it's obviously for all of them. Okay, here we go, 14. That's, it won't do it. Anyway, the 14 is the one I've got. USB 3.0 Type A, so they call that Type A. That is, I've never seen, I've seen the Type A's and the standards and looked at them, and I've never seen one with a double pinch connector like that's got. I did show that, didn't I? I don't know if I actually showed it this end for more than a second. Let's see if I can do it. Okay, there it is. It's pinched in the middle. It's very short. It won't stay in. It's just like now. This is the Western Digital, but it looks just like the WD. I mean, reversed. I said Western Digital. It looks just like the Seagate. Okay, now back to desktop. Okay. So, yeah, it's formatted in Windows NTFS. Now, that's the first thing I'm going to do once I get it, see that it's working and everything, is I'm going to reformat it with, I'm going to use Ext4 because I run Linux, and that's the best, the one I like the best, easiest to use. And I don't think I've ever seen a, better not say that, but I've never seen an Ext4 partition break, maybe once. But the NTFS on that 5 terabyte, and it's still NTFS because it's broken 3-4 times, and that's what gets some bad reviews is a lot of times is because, you know, they say it worked for a week or a few days or 2 months and then it quit. Well, so did that one, but I knew how to fix it. It wasn't the physical damage or anything. It was the partition that was broken. And you can, now if you're running Windows, you don't want to use EXT, or you got to make sure you use one that Windows can read, and it can't read that, unless you find out, there used to be some programs that would read EXT 2 and 3, but I haven't even looked in years, so I don't, I don't have a machine that's running Windows, so, okay, I'm getting to that point where I'm, now that my throat's dry and I'm talking, I'm getting those uncontrollable coughs. And I am still having drain. All of a sudden the drainage came back. So anyway, I'm going to get a cough drop. So you can read that for a minute. I'm going to try to get this cough drop out of here. You done? Good. I'm done. Okay, so there's not much on that. The other one, is more of a manual. See, that's too small to read. Let's see if the, it won't zoom in anymore either. I don't know if something's gone. Usually all I have to do is just hit Control Plus when the sorry. To zoom in, Control Plus to zoom in, Control Minus to zoom out. And it's not working. But, oh, there it goes. There you go. I don't know why it wasn't working. Oh, it's zoomed in as far as you can go. Now, still can't read that. I mean, you might be able to on your computer, but on my Ultra 4K 42-inch monitor, it gets really, really small. But, you know, it doesn't get blurry because it really is a good monitor. And it's a Walmart monitor. Oh, no. OBS disconnected. Something happened to my stream. It did reconnect. Let's go check the stream. I'll end up having to upload this video now. I don't know why it would disconnect. Me never do know why. Just goes to show you, it's always something. Right when you think everything's working, it's been working, you know, it should be all right. Boom, it quits working. Yeah, this, there's something with this page that makes it load so slow. Back to excellent. Okay. All this makes sure the sound is good.
Just to show you.
Oh boy, you can really hear me smacking that cough drop. Sorry. Okay. Of course, here's the pictures of how to plug it up. You know, if you didn't know already. And I made sure I looked at this part with the Seagates when I got them, but oh, and at Macintosh, you have to reformat them to whatever. I don't even know what, I've never had a Mac, so I don't know what file system they use, but I know it's different. So, don't think there's really anything that I want to get into reading on any of that. But there it all is, and I believe I downloaded it from the Amazon page where I ordered it. I think sometimes they put a link to this stuff. I'm going to close it because, yeah, it's got all kinds of stuff that you can read for hours if you want to, but we just want to plug it in. Okay, there's my video that I'm making. I always like to be able to see if it's still working. You see, like, I'm going to end up probably uploading it unless it doesn't really make much difference, you know, when I watch the video back. The work. Shit. We lost connection and then came back. I just realized what my other problem is. December the 9th, it's 79 degrees outside in North Texas, near Fort Worth. 79.3 in my room. Got that little fan in the window. I guess I better turn it up a little more. And it's been nice for a couple of weeks. We did have a couple of days that were like 77, 78 outside. But that's the anything over 77 starts getting hot in this house. I got one window open. I could open another one, but it may not even change the temperature, really. I wasn't really feeling hot until right. I'm starting to now. 79. If it was closed up in here and it was 79, it would be burning me up. I wouldn't be able to breathe. Didn't get the mic on. Well, I was switching mics. Okay. So, let's do this because all we need to see of the plug-in thingy is just where you plug it in. Let's see. Yeah, I've got all my USBs on the server full, but this one goes to the server. Of course, it won't be, I'm not going to do speed tests or anything. It wouldn't be very as fast as it could be because this is going through a 15 or more foot cable. It's got about, it doesn't have a very long cable on it, about 3 to 5 feet. I think it's about 3 to 4 feet, really, going to that 15 foot cable, I think. It does have a, the cable has a buck converter built into it, I think, to what we would call it, to
keep the voltage dropping too much. About to lose my mind here. Yeah, if I'd have felt up to doing this video these cool days, would have been a lot better. I don't think I'd have been, well, I can't say I wouldn't have been coughing. The allergies have been bad. But if I try to wait for, when I'm not going to cough, then I would never do it. Yeah, suddenly my nose started running like a faucet. I don't even know why. Let me turn the fan up over there in the window. There. Yeah, when I turn it up that high, I can hear it real good. I don't think it'll get into the video, but... When something like that happens, it ruins your video. Not done yet. Not done with the runny nose. Yeah, when you're doing it live, you get what you get. Good, the bad, and the ugly. Then you wonder, well, maybe if I wouldn't have taken that, it was a cold pill and an allergy pill is what I always take. Maybe I'd have done better, but won't know now. And these lapels are connected right on my shirt. I can't get them off. You know, when you're fixing a cough, you don't have time to do anything but just cough. This is turning out to be the worst allergy fit I've had in a year, so 6 months or a year. Making a video. Well, I was making a video. If I'd have known that was going to happen, I could have at least switched to my background music or something. But that's always weird and bad. That's right. When, if you do that, then people will just say, oh, I guess I'm not going to, you know, I'm done. They think I'm done or they're done or whatever, you know. So, can't even get nowhere. Getting beside myself. Don't hardly know what I'm supposed to be doing. Well, at least once the video was done, anybody was watching, they can always skip ahead. Okay. I knew it was supposed to get, they said it could get up to 81 today. I kept hoping it wouldn't. But it is 79 in Fort Worth, and then in my room now it's 79.5. So it must be pretty much the same here. Okay, now. So what I'm going to do, yeah, I'll go ahead and plug it in here, I think. Yeah, you know, I think you need to plug in the cables and then, you know, the USB cable and then do the power. But I'm going to plug this in. That's the power. And then... plug in the you gotta pay attention to which way it goes, which I could kind of just see it, I think. Yeah, there we go. Oh yeah, that'd come out in a heartbeat. See, even just wiggling it could cause it to disconnect on the Seagate, so I bet it'll do that on here. Normally I leave them sitting up like that. I'm gonna lay it down so that it won't turn over too easy. Kind of a stiff cable. Now I'm gonna plug it in. Bound to be some way to do that without having to fight it so much. Okay. Oh yeah, I was waiting for it to power up, but it's not ready to power up yet. Now I've got a power strip down here that I can plug the power into. Now it should power up. I thought maybe we'd see a light or something come on. Okay, it's quiet, but I do hear the drive spinning up, or spinning. I think it was already, oh, now you can feel it. Huh. I don't know if that'll show up on the camera, but yeah, look at that. That's a little light blinking in there. Oh, here it is. The light's on the front. Yeah, you see, just now I really completely forgot to be more careful with the cable. Neither one of these companies should have made something like that with a not solid. I forgot what I wanted to do is with all my coughing and everything. I lost my head. I nearly coughed my head off. Let's see. Nose is draining again. I wanted to hang on. Fix it now. Drainage all over my shirt if I don't. Did you ever watch, what's the name of that? The guy that took over for Stargate is, you know, kind of the main guy. He had a show, Farscape. I'm getting to it here in a minute. Can't think of anybody's name. I did know their names, but Richard Dean Anderson was the first, the captain, Colonel O'Neill. And then now the guy from Forest Gate, he wasn't playing Colonel O'Neill, he was playing as somebody else, you know. But anyway, he took over in that spot. And on Farscape, it was a cool show. I really got a bit. I've never seen one like it. Made in for Australia. And they had people and puppets. And it was believable and it was well done. And they and the people would him and another girl, dark haired girl. You know, they had a love-hate relationship going on. But he loved her and she hated him. but I think she loved him in the end. But she was just playing hard to get. But anyway, all the rest of them wore this wild makeup, you know. They were aliens to us Earthlings. And there was one episode where they had said they'd called in the doctor for him because there's something wrong with him. Went to a planet somewhere, get one of the best doctor ever. Now I'm blowing the dust off my glasses. It's just another thing that sounds terrible on the mic, doesn't it? And, okay, the guy's nose was running. He was all in a character, you know, made up and everything, but his nose was constantly running. I don't know how they did it because it really had something dripping off his nose, and it never quit. And he kept looking. And they had brought him in to see him, and that guy, the character, was just talking to him, asking him a few questions. He wasn't saying too much. I think he was talking in an alien language or something, too. And he didn't understand it, but the others did, or one of the others did. And he was like, God, what is this guy, you know? And one of them, I think it was the black-haired girl, scolded him, said, this is the finest doctor, you know, in this galaxy or whatever. And you're being disrespectful. And he got some of that drippings off his nose and put it on his eyes or whatever. I don't know what was wrong with him, but it made him well. So that's all this is. You know, it's just trying to make me well. Something in my body that's not good for it, and my body's trying to get rid of it. I've about rubbed my nose raw now. I like Bounty paper towels, but for 30 years or more, I've been carrying them in my pocket for, like, you know, handkerchiefs. And I still use them because I haven't seen anything any better. But for at least the last 20 years, they're making them out of sandpaper. They used to be very absorbent, strong, plenty strong, and softer than a Kleenex. Of course, I can't use a Kleenex. I blow straight through it the first time, every time. Always have. But, okay, so there's my story. Okay, so this thing is, I'll just go straight to the desktop. I was going to show them both at the same time, the desktop and the, and I forgot it. So we'll go to the desktop now. There it is. It doesn't show it as the, it just says elements. It doesn't say, oh, I renamed that one. It said Seagate expansion, backup or expansion driver, whatever. I named it to 8 terabyte USB. I'll do that with this one too. I guess I could. No, I won't do it till after I get done doing stuff with it. Get it set up. But, that light. Oh, here we go. it actually helps me see my keyboard. But it's shining on my mic. Oh, that's what I can do. I need to switch mics anyway. A lot of times that will keep the, like I said, keep the wireless mic from, when you get off of it and you stop the streams, what happens when you get off of it.
That's how I have it set up in OBS Studio. And so that gives the Wi-Fi a break. And I think it also helps, I think it causes the cache to clear in the computer or in OBS or wherever the cache is stored. Okay, so now we're back on the ES58. And so there it is, elements right there. So I still have this already open anyway, so you should be able to just go right to it. But like I said, it's an NTFS. Where is it? There it is, 12.7 terabyte. That's all you get out of a 14 terabyte drive. That's 7's often close to, 0.5. But there it is. And there's the Windows application. Software for Mac. Oh, that's a Mac. DMG, I'm sure, is a Mac program. A file extension. EXE, of course, Windows. Of course, neither one of those would run on this machine. You can install some things you can't just run an EXE straight in Linux. But you can run it in Wine or Wine, the Windows emulator. But and then what's this? Settings.dat, WP Settings.dat. Okay. Now, one thing, I'm going ahead and back. I'm going to back those up. So I think I'll. I'm going to move that. I'm going to make them like that, and then I'm going to get to my. I can just put it on the main. I'm just going to put it in my documents folder. It'll be fine. I think. I never find it that way, but I wanted to go ahead and put it on here, and then it will end up backing up to the 8 terabyte drive whenever my backups run. But let's do. Oh yeah, I need to make a folder for the Western Digital anyway. So, it mounted. It just took forever. it's still getting hotter. 79.7. This is the default file manager for Fedora Linux, and it just takes forever to do things. It's how long it took. KJ, and it also acts up. I don't like that Windows style file manager anyway. I like the Crusader twin panel. I learned about it used to be Windows Commander, and then when Microsoft sued them and they had to change their name to Total Commander, but I still use that if I'm on a Windows machine. I bought it way back then. But so this is quite a bit like it. I'm more used to this one now than the other Commander one, but because I've been using this since 2005. But that's when I got into Linux. Okay, documents. What I was going to do, let's go to the downloads. There we go. I wanted to copy this so I wouldn't mess up. WD, I really want to call it Western Digital. There, that's what I want. I don't want that whole thing. And I think I will. (Clears throat) Documents is not really where I usually put that stuff. Let's put it in downloads. Yeah, it would make more sense. Make folder, our directory. I'm just going to go ahead and put, sometimes Western Digital, I'm going to take the WD part out of there. I don't need that. 14, I don't want to take the one out of there. Western Digital, I like to copy and paste because I always misspell things. I'll leave it like that. I was debating about whether I should, you know, just leave spaces or do it like that with the dashes. Western Digital. Pretty sure that's right. If it's wrong, I can fix it. See, it just says elements. So I don't want to fix that now, change that now, because then it won't be, it'll unmount it, and it'll be a problem. But now I can copy that over, because when I format it, that's all going to be gone, and I might, for some reason, want it back. Okay. This is fixing to get reformatted, so that will erase everything on it. But I was really sorry. I got a bunch of data on that 5 terabyte drive, and that's the only one I had for 2 or 3 years or 4 before I bought the 8 terabyte. So I couldn't change it from NTFS to Ext4, 3 or 4, whatever I wanted at the time. So I just got stuck that way. And then when I bought the 8 terabyte drive, I ended up making them, for a while I made them mirrors of each other. I don't know why I didn't go ahead and do it then. There's some reason why I didn't. I don't remember now. Probably just because it would have took so long to copy, 3 and a half terabyte of data. But, let's see, what do I want? Going to the wrong place. No, I do not want to delete it. I tried to hit enter, and I hit enter and delete at the same time. Luckily, always tell it to ask you if you really want to do that, because Crusader can just delete them instantly without asking, and then you really have a headache. Yeah, I was just trying to hit enter to go in there. Okay. Here's what I'm wanting to do. There we go. I'm just going to go ahead and move those over there. You see, that's why I decided to put it in downloads, because that's what they really are. See, there's a Seagate expansion drive info that I had downloaded at some point recently. That shows the little PDF icon, but it doesn't have the PDF on it. The file extension, I did not notice that. Now it does. Some applications can't open them up if they don't have the extension. Yeah. It's basically the same as far as the connectors and stuff. I don't know which one that one's for. Anyway, there that is. I just didn't realize it was right there next to it. Okay. And I'm going to do some formatting, so since I already have it mounted in here, I'm going to need to close that program so it'll let go of it. It'll hold on to it if you don't. Now, let's get our camera back up. I'm going to go over there to the closet and
I'm going to turn off that 8 terabyte drive because I don't want to accidentally delete everything on it when I start formatting this drive. Sometimes it can be a bit of a pain. You might even have to reboot to get it to show back up, but it'd be well worth it, not losing anything. Yeah, and I wouldn't wiggle these cables while you're doing formatting and stuff. You could end up, I don't know if you'd brick it, but it could really give you a headache. But, okay, let's get this. I'm not going to get a handheld. Well, I could. Yeah, I will. It's the only way you're going to see what it is I'm going to be doing. This is a pretty cool tripod. You unscrew a little deal. Let me get the cable out from where it is first, because I know it's going to be tangled up and stuff. It plugs into the computer via USB. Oh, I have got stuff all around it to where there's no way I'm getting it out of there without a real problem. So I'm just going to belay that idea. I need to tighten that thing back up. It's letting it turn too easy. Oops, that's too tight. That's what handles your... Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, that should be tight if you're not using it, because the pan... it's a different button. It's fine. It's a little stiff, but that's fine. Now, I don't think you'll be able to see in there, though. Yeah, you can't see in there at all. I kind of don't want to. I guess I can do that. I don't think I'm going to be. Let me shut that until I'm ready to get in there. That's going to let heat come in here. The last thing we need. Okay, I believe I can just turn this other one around that way. I have it set perfectly on the monitor, but I realize now that I'm probably not going to be showing the monitor. I was thinking I would. Also, we'll see what we can see. It's frozen up. Isn't that special? Yeah, it's either so far behind or it's frozen up completely. Well, I think I saw my shoulder. It's just way behind. That one is, this particular camera keeps doing that. There it goes. Sometimes you can, it'll straighten back up. They're bad about doing that. Let me see if it will straighten up. I think it's trying to catch up. Let's go back. I sometimes go into the desktop. And then coming back, matter of fact, let's just check our stream. I don't leave this stuff open all the time because even though this is got 2 6-core processors and 64 gig of RAM, it will still be a little, it won't shut this, make the thing, it just lags. It won't, it'll make it, the fans go real hard and it'll work hard and make more heat, noise. And so, okay, so that seems good. Let's make sure I don't. Yeah, okay, now I see what I'm doing here, so. All right, and I heard Sam, heard me grunting, so all's good. All right, now, let's see if this thing will actually catch right back up. I did strictly with these, yeah, okay, it's good again. Okay, with 2 cameras for video and phones for video and 1 for audio, I did it for years, but it's not always the best thing, really. Okay, I think that's enough to give you the idea. You can't see. What I'm going to do is, all I'm going to do right now is unplug the, it's plugged into the back of the server, so it's really hard to get to. I have to actually twist the server around to was definitely to get it back in there. You know, I can get it out maybe, but I couldn't get it back in. But I was going to say, you can't see the drive lights, but there's one that's yellow and it's not using it. And so I already had one go bad, and I took it out of the last one and put it in that spot. And it was a different spot because I looked back at my old videos. So I got to do that. But I'm not even going to do that today because all this coughing, I'm getting tired. I got up at like 1 o'clock in the morning. I've been up a long time now. Oh, yeah, it's almost 4 now. Is it? I can't see that far. So anyway, all I'm going to do is unplug the power to the drive. All that, just for that. Okay, so, just to do that. But, you know, when you're making videos, if you just say, I'm going to do something, and if somebody's trying to understand how things work, sometimes they don't. They don't know what you're talking about. So I like to show up as much as I can. Yeah, this is what I didn't want. Why I didn't want to move it. The reason I did all this, though, was setting it up like that, was because I thought I was going to be rebooting the machine. I was just going to hot swap it, but then it probably wouldn't try to. It wouldn't try to fix the data. Every time it boots up, it says it's going to try to fix the data, but it can't because it's not going to use that drive. The other one turned red in it, and it would not talk to it at all anymore. This one's still yellow. But, and that's why I decided to go ahead and buy this big drive, because my original plan had been to let's go ahead and get you around the corner here. The original plan when I got the server, I'd watched a lot of Morton, my Playhouse channel. He's where I learned most everything I know about servers. And anyway, he was buying these kind of, you know, these backup USB backup drives. With the, you know, different. I think he bought different brands. He just kind of, I think, kind of just got what was on best price, but. You take them out of the case, they call it, somebody you know that's watching his channel called it shuck. They said they call it shucking the hard drive. And he's like he lives in Denmark. And he speaks really good English now. When I first started watching his channel three or four years ago, I guess, it was a little hard to understand, but now I don't even think about it anymore. But anyway, except for sometimes he has trouble pronouncing things that, you know, most. I'm used to. I can't say forever American, but did something today. I was watching the video, but anyway, he called it. He was calling it chucking. He finally decided it was called chucking, and of course, chucking is throwing something. So that, of course, was obviously didn't make sense. But I don't think he was familiar with shucking or shucking sh or chucking ch. So I probably don't say it the way, you know, people in other parts of America would say it. Probably doesn't sound right to them. Anyway, that's how that goes. What was my point? Okay, so that was my plan, is to buy some hard drives. And I was that very first 5 terabyte, I was thinking, okay, I'm gonna chuck this thing. I'm going to chuck it, and I'm going to make it be my main drive, or make it be my backup drive is what I was going to do. But then I had done some research. You know, it took, from the time I started planning it to the time I did it was probably a couple of years. And by the time I got the drives and the server, I got the drive way before I got the server, and I already had it filled. I had a whole bunch of data on it, backing it up from my regular Lenovo machine I was using as my little, it's one of those miniature ones, you know, that they generally for inner, you know, they use them in offices, they call them enterprise, but it's really just a laptop in a box is all it is. But anyway, it has laptop memory and not much of a processor. It's an i5, but it's not a fast processor. And, you know, it only has a VGA output. It didn't have anything. But it was given to me, and it served me for 4 or 5 years. So anyway, blank. I finally found out that, and just recently I find out sometimes more good information by reading the reviews on Amazon. That's where I bought this. People will give you some good tips, you know, and you can go and look it up and figure out, yeah, they're right. But I just saw some, it wasn't Morton, it was somebody else that I was watching, or maybe I was reading it, I can't remember now, but just recently, so yeah, it was a video, and it was explaining, I can't even think of the words they use, but there's a certain way, and it was from the videos when I was looking back, I was shopping back in the summer, and they were just outrageously expensive, but I thought, I'll wait until, when that last hard drive went bad, I was like, okay, once I swap that other one that's, I'm not using, I left two out of my array, I made an array of, there's 8 hard drives that can go in the front of that, and I'd use 6 of them in a drive pool, an array, whatever you want, however way it should be said, and a virtual drive, okay? I had 6 drives into 1 virtual drive, 1 big drive, and a RAID 5. That's how I set it up. Left the other 2, and at first I didn't do anything with them. They were just, you know, not formatted. But then I decided, you know what, I could use those. They're not big, but they're 146 gigabytes, so it's enough to do stuff with. And so Fedora has, I was playing with virtual machines, and I thought, well, I need a place to put those, and I don't want to take up my space. So I formatted them in Fedora, not with the RAID controller. And they worked perfectly. Played with virtual machines just a little bit. I run a web server, have for years, with my websites on it. I used to run it on old desktops. Now it's running on an old laptop because the desktops, I didn't want to spend money on them, you know, like the fans would go bad or this or that or the other. And I don't really like doing it on a laptop. It's too hard on them. It makes the power supplies wear. I've already wore out the power supply on one, an Acer. That's a Dell I got up there now. And this one, I think it's going to, sometimes it stays awake for, it seems like several days, and it'll go to sleep when I don't know it. And then my website will be offline. And so I didn't realize that's what was going on. Because when I go to look at it, you know, I touch it and it wakes up. But it doesn't always wake up. Sometimes you have to press the power button and then it wakes up. It's not like you have to boot it back up. It just was asleep. And I've tried to figure out how to make it not do that, but I don't know that you can on that laptop. And see, they're made to save power, you know. And they also don't have in the BIOS. Desktops always have where you can tell at what state, like if the power lost, like if your power goes out in your house, when it comes back on, what do we want it to do? Go back like it was, stay off, go back on. Or you can just set it to always go back on, and then when the power comes back, your server, your routers, your modems come back up, and your server comes back up. That works really well. Servers, real servers don't do that. They expect you to have your power figured out yourself. So if the power goes off on the server, and it has, then you have to, it's not going to come back on until you turn it on. But, so anyway, I'm getting all off one side and down the other. Okay, the drives, they're saying that most of these USB drive, backup drives are a particular kind of drive that it ends up writing really slowly. They're not meant to for fast access. They're meant to back up a lot of data. And I don't think the read speeds are slow necessarily on there's a particular way. I wish I knew what that was. I've got it in link somewhere, but it'd take forever to find it. Anyway, they write really slowly. So that's fine for backing up. You're not going to notice it. You know, it's just running in the background. But if you put it as your hard drive for your operating system, you're going to notice it. And it's probably going to be pretty poor performance. Well, these SAS drives, that's what the server came with 8 SAS drives. They're fast. They're the fastest spinning hard drive you can get. And so that I said, I'm going to use them. Well, they may, I think they're, I won't be able to argue the point of, between that and SSDs. I don't pay enough attention to the exact specs of everything. I don't have an SSD. I've never owned one. I've seen lots of, Morton loves those things. He always runs speed testing, you know, them next to the drives. And different brands of drives are different speeds, even within the SAS drives, you know. Different ages, of course. The older they are, the slower they would be compared to the newer ones. This server and those drives were made in 2011. So, you know, they're not the newest thing. But when they started going, you know, when the first one went bad and now when this one went bad, I started looking for replacement drives. And the... you know, with everything going skyrocketing in price, I wasn't going to pay those. I did find some 1.46 gigabyte SAS drives for $15 on a site that I had bought some fans for. Some back, I didn't use them. I just bought some backup fans for the server in case they went out. They were $2, and they were, back then they were a year or so ago. They were free shipping to $2. I bought two fans. I just wanted to see if the company was. I liked ordering from them if they. Sent you what they said they would if you had any trouble with them. I didn't want to order anything big, you know. Now, you know, you got to pay shipping. They put shipping on it. So, you know, small things like that. Like if I bought two of those drives for $15 each, I'd pay $15 for shipping. So I'm not going to do that. And then I got to thinking, now why? I got to think about my original plan. I thought, well, you know, just for backing up, my whole idea was to put two. At the time, like 8, I thought maybe 10, but there, I don't think they even had 14 terabyte drives available at that time. I know they had 10, maybe some 12s, but anyway, I thought I'll put two of them in there and make a RAID 5 out of those two drives, and then I'll have a redundant backup. But that was costly back then, and now it's even more costly. So I'm going to just stick with my 5 terabyte, you know, it started filling up, so I couldn't keep on mirroring it with the 8 terabyte. Once I got my server, I just left the 5 terabyte on my old desktop so it could still be backed up. And then the server has the 8 terabyte as the backup drive, just on the USB. It's got 1.5, I think it's still got about 2 terabytes left. And so I was getting to where I was going to need some more backup space. So now I've got the 14 or 13.7 terabytes of backup. And I think since I don't have a lot of USBs, I may, well, like I'll plug them in. I'll plug this in. And I think what I'll, I don't know. I was thinking I would copy everything on the 8 terabyte to this one and then go from, and then it would be free for me to do anything I wanted with it. But now I'm just now thinking, I think I better just leave it as is. If it's not plugged in, it can't get damaged by lightning or anything. I mean, I've got protective power strips and everything, but that's supposed to protect from that. But, you know, crazy things can happen. So I may just, once I get it set up and everything, I'm going to do it today because I'm getting tired. My throat's, you know, I won't do it in this video. But I think what I may do is, just unplug that 8 terabyte and plug this one in as my main. That'll be my new backup drive. And then if I need anything off of that, I can just plug it in. I can plug it in, you know, right here to this USB hub. And even though it'll be a little bit slower if I need to get a file off of it, I won't be getting, you know, 7 terabytes of data off of it. You know, I'll just be getting a maybe, you know, 5 or 10 gigabytes, but nothing. I wouldn't be doing a whole lot of files at once. So let's go to the desktop again. What am I talking on? Oh, okay, I'm on the wireless. Okay, let's get more comfortable. Get back to the other mic.
Okay, now we'll get on. We're on the desktop. And let's see. You can tell that you do have a connection here on. It says you're live, and I mean, if you're dropping frames or not dropping frames, how long I've been going, 1 hour and 25 minutes. The CPU usage and the frames per second, and then the kilobits per second. It's doing okay. Oh yeah, 6,200 kilobits per second. That's pretty good. And this is in the it's being streamed in 4K. So and I when I first started doing that, I started I was having trouble with caching and stuff. I figured out I had to raise that up a little bit, but I only have 10 up and have 200 down, but I only have 10 up. So I think that's 6 gigabits. So that's using a big chunk of my internet upload speed right there. Okay, so the drive, it's plugged in, but see now the 8 terabytes gone. It was under there. Okay, so now let's see. I'm gonna just show you what I got. Let's see. Disk. Okay, disk management, mount and unmount file systems. Don't want that. Disk manage drives and media. I don't think that's the one I want either. Disk scrubber. I don't know why I got that on there. I think I got that in a group install. I don't want to scrub any disk. Disk usage analyzer. Now, see, that would probably... Oh, that's just the space. It's not the speed or anything like that. But, and it, well, there it is, 14 terabyte available, and of course it says 14. Now that program's a line program because we know we don't actually have 14 terabytes. You'll notice the difference between programs. I don't remember ever seeing that before. And of course the 8 terabytes unplugged, so. Okay. Now. That's not the one I usually use. There's another one where you can just dive really deep into the... I don't think it is. It didn't look like it. I haven't looked at it in a long time. Test disk. That is a really good program for recovering lost partitions and stuff. I've used it for years. It's a command line program, but it's got a... I guess you could call it a... It's not really a wizard like next, next, next. It's text and then... Hit one or hit this or hit that to do what you want to do. It tells you basically, if you know anything about, you have to understand, you have to know about formatting and, you know, I guess you really kind of have to know, pretty well know about drives and partitions and file systems and stuff to get through it. But anyway, securely erase this. There's another one. Yeah, I installed a bunch of groups in here. Okay, so. Yeah, that's disk does not find. Oh, that's weird. It went away. I just went all the way up with. I don't even know how to make it quit doing that, with the keyboard. Media writer, video viewer, capture, QV, PC view. That's not what I want either. Disk drive. I keep hitting the wrong thing. Now I've got some other crazy thing going on in there. Keep hitting the wrong keys. Gparted is the one, yeah. Gparted. Oh, they're both Gparted, but that one has the icon. And then KDIF, file and directory comparison. Parallelized ping. Harris Trace Route. Yeah, it's crazy. Okay, I like Gparted very much. And you got to put in the root password. I think I remembered. I haven't been doing things where I need to type it in for quite a while. Just make it big enough to see it because I'm going to open up another program. And since the way my monitor is here in this my room, I have it. It's, oh, I guess it's five feet off. It's 5 feet or so off the ground. And I'm looking up at it, which is fine. I'm comfortable sitting here like this. I like it because I have my old monitor down here on the desk, and I still use it sometimes for the other computers. So anyway, but up at the very top, I can't read things too well, especially if they're this one. I might be able to read, but anyway. Okay, so this is my my six disk array. My I keep calling it, I think Anyway, this is what my operating system's on. 638.5 gigabytes. Then there is 136 gigabyte. That's the other drive I was talking about. It says it's unallocated. This is the other 146 gigabyte drive. Loose 10 gigabytes. Huh. I think G-parted may just, yeah. I could have erased it. I may have in preparation for putting it. I didn't want it to cause any trouble with that with the file system that was written by Fedora. If there was anything between, I'm very big a beginner in RAID. You know, I got things. I learned how to set it up and got it set up, but I don't know all the ins and outs. I may have done that. So anyway, that's what that is. That's my other that I'm going to unplug and plug into where that one with the yellow light is. But I'm not going to do that today. Now I was planning on it. Okay, so NTFS, let's make it wide enough where everything shows up. Will it show up? It's not going to do it. This one here, I don't think you can get, yeah, you can get a hold of it and drag it. Let's try it. If I can, you got to really be accurate. There we go. I wanted it to show everything. Okay. So, Dev SDD1 is the address it gave it, the drive letter number, whatever. It doesn't know ABCDs in Linux. So elements is the name it's got. NTFS, that run media elements, that's where you'd find it. Again, label elements. 12.73 terabytes is the actual space. Used 511 megabytes. Yeah, so see some of that stuff. I think that might be a hidden partition. Well, if it was a hidden partition, it would show up. So that must be what, you know, those files I backed up, they must actually be 511 megabytes. And unused, 1273. And then unallocated is the whole, it's 1 megabyte. So we're going to want, we'll be needing to keep that. You still want to keep that when you reformat it. So now I'm going to look at it in another program before I do any of that. But you got to be very careful you don't get on the wrong drive. And G-parted, it's really easy to make sure you're on the right one. As you can, I think you can see that there. Okay, so this time I can't remember. Usually I do better with searching, but you can go through here, but I have so many programs, see. But I'm hitting the keyboard keys on the keyboard. Try to get it to. I'm just hitting D now because it didn't work. Disk manager? No. Let's see if that's it. Yeah. No. This one I've never used it because it always just says that you got to be a root user to use it. It doesn't give you the chance to become root user. So and it's always on. It just comes. Now that one comes with Fedora. Always has since Fedora 5. I don't know what it's supposed to be good for. You can't use it. All right. I can't remember the name of the programs is my problem. And I'm not good at looking through long lists. That's why I always go straight to the searcher. Let's go back to the search because my eyes are a little blurry. Let's look through there one more time. I didn't really try. Do it this way. Ah, must have hit the wrong key. I used to be really good at, you know, navigating on the keyboard, but I'm constantly hitting the wrong thing. A lot of these are command line apps that I couldn't run save my life because you got to know the commands. Some of them will tell you, but most of them don't. I installed a bunch of groups on here and I got all kinds of crazy things. I knew better, but I did it anyway. I was exploring, and I'm talking and not looking. And sometimes these programs get put in different folders, you know, different areas, and I don't remember it. From from version to version, from year to year. Yeah, there's so much stuff just in this folder right here. I call it folder because it is really how it's done. I mean, I know they call it something else, but yeah, I installed this security group, and that's where I got a whole bunch of this command line apps. But also, I couldn't remember the name of some of the GUI apps I wanted, and that was the quickest way I knew to get the ones I wanted. Okay, so it's not in there. Oops. Accessories. See, the coughing is fine. My throat's sore as it can be, but the coughing, all that coughing and everything. But I'm not going nuts anymore. Finally quit. It's also dry up. I don't sit around talking much, you know, when I'm on the computer. I mumble to myself, but I don't talk out loud. And it's funny when you don't do that, you don't talk much, your voice gets hoarse and your throat hurts really quickly. But all that coughing's why it hurts, I'm sure, because usually I get like 3 or 4 hours before I get like this. But my throat's pretty sore just from all that coughing. So I'll just stop on each one, see. Yeah, there's a security lab. All that came from that group, security lab. Most everything in that group is command line. There's only a few, 3 or 4 that I could use. Sound and video, there's lots and lots of cool stuff in there. I just went through the system tools. Oh, there's one of them. Believe it. I thought that they were in there. Okay, this is the other one that I wanted to look in. Normally, I like to make every program I use completely full screen, but this screen is so big, it really makes it kind of hard to use. I don't like that white. I like the background. I need to go find me like a real picture. This is like a digitized thing. It's been, the waterfall's been faked, but it's too bright. I can't look. You see, way up there, it's just too far up for me to read it. It gets smaller, and it's just up there too far. There we go. That's good enough. Maybe a little bit more like that. The white, that whiteness hurts my eyes. Okay. Now, see, here's a real good a good view to be looking at, though. It helps you understand what's going on with the drive. This is a lot. That's what I was trying to say. Logical volume. LVM. This, Fedora has always, since Fedora 5, when I got into Fedora, it's always, I had to learn about all this logical volume stuff. I know how to work with it and everything. There was even a GUI tool for working with logical volumes. It was awesome, but you're supposed to be able to like resize drives and move things around without losing any data. I never did it. I was scared it wouldn't work. But I needed to, but I didn't on my old machine, like Fedora 14 or, well, probably before that. But anyway, it has gone away since, I think, Fedora 14. I still have it on my old machine with Fedora 14 on it. I can't let go of them because there's all, especially, you know, everything being open source and free and volunteers doing it, building these programs and maintaining them. After 5 or 8 years, sometimes they'll just quit being made and they're not, but they'll still work if you still have it on your, you know, older version. Okay, so anyway, this is the boot partition. That is the LVM with my home. They didn't used to do it this way, but they do now. Home and root used to be its own separate partition. SDA 3, 32 gigabyte. That's the swap partition. Yeah, down here it tells you a little more info. What's this one? I think I need to make it wider to be able to read it. or else it, maybe it won't come up. They've started doing this. Sometimes, I think maybe I can do that. Yeah, okay. Yeah, you can do that. Some programs, you can't do it. You can't ever, you're never going to read the words because they make them to fit. It's like they're trying to make a whole real operating system fit on a phone or a tablet. It just aggravates me to death. I didn't buy a 42-inch monitor to not be able to read everything. I bought it so I could. Same thing with my old monitor. It was a 20, it's a 23-inch, I think. And I was so happy when I finally got a monitor wide enough to be able to read everything without having to page up and down and back and forth. But then they changed the way everything's designed. At first, it was just on the internet. Now it's in the programs. But anyway, this worked, and so stopped graphing. So this logical volume, 136.7 gigabyte, that is that other drive. This is just a single drive all by itself, and it's just got free space on it. I know I had it formatted, so I must have erased it in preparation for plugging it into that other slot. Now, the elements, that is the actual drive right there, and then that's the LVM, probably of it, we'll see. No, it doesn't have an LVM. It's got NTFS. So no, I don't. We'll see what that is in a minute. So SDD1 is its label, and it will always get that same one once it, you know, once it's seen it. I think it does. If you unplugged it and then plugged another drive in and stuff, like say if I unplug this one, which I'm gonna do, if I can remember, what I'm saying is I don't usually like that other 8 terabyte in this. They won't usually swap, but I think if you're plugging in, that will happen. But I did do one thing with the 8 terabyte. Sometimes it wouldn't mount. I don't know why, but sometimes it wouldn't mount. I thought there was a problem with it at first, but then I finally realized it's something to do with the operating system. Well, it might still been something to do with the drive, but anyway, it didn't always mount. And it was aggravating to have to try to get it to mount. And so there was something popped up, I believe, that said, do you want to tell this to always mount, or I found it somewhere, you know, in the settings, and I turned it on, and so it's mounted every time since. And I mean, unless, you know, unless there was some kind of hardware issue, I don't remember it not mounting since then. And but I found out one day when I was fiddling around, like I want to unplug it, and then I was going to reboot the machine to do whatever, maybe install something on a USB stick or something like that, and I didn't want to accidentally have a brain fart and put it on that and erase everything. The machine would not boot up with it unplugged. If you tell it to, and that's the other thing. Fedora used to have to learn everything and understand how it worked to do it. And even if some of you had to, I remember you always having to edit the etcfs tab file so that drives would mount. Well, that sucked. They finally got it to where it was automatic for you and everything. But now, they change the wording, and they're always dumbing everything down to the point that it makes no sense. And if you already knew how it worked, you can't even figure out what to click on. They've been doing that since about Fedora 19 or 20. And all the, I don't understand why, you know, they're trying to make it easier, but it makes it, I guarantee it doesn't make it harder for anybody that doesn't understand it, because you'd have no clue what you're doing or what's going to happen if you didn't already know something about it. I mean, there's some things you got to learn to use it. And if you can't learn, if you don't want to learn it, or you know, you can't learn it, then you should probably just use something else. And that happens in Windows, too. They've been doing it for longer. But anyway, I didn't know I was in a ranty mood. All right. So NTFS, 12.73 terabyte. I don't want it to be NTFS. That's my whole point here. And I believe I will go ahead and use Gparted to do the formatting. Now, what's this other one? And there's a view of the, well, there's a logical view, and then there's a physical view in there, see. Now, this is where it really is on the drive, I think. It doesn't look like it. What in the world? The physical view does not make sense to me. The older way they did it, well, I don't know if it ever did put it in the order that made sense to me, but, you know, at the beginning of the drive, I know that it's going to have the, this one right here. No, not that one. This one, root. Oh, 100 gigabyte. No, it's gonna. It's not even showing it. Okay, this is a new Blivet GUI. That's the newest one they have, and it's doing that. At the beginning of the drive, let's go look at that same thing. Okay, SDA. At the beginning of the drive, it's even in the right order, SDA1. That is the boot, 1 gigabyte boot partition. The LVM, this is actually LVM2 now. Well, it's LVM PV LVM now. LVM2 PV LVM, that's its name, full name now. It changed. It's different than the way it used to be with just LVM. So on the LVM, logical volume the management, that logical volume is 650 gigabyte. And then there's the swap, 32 gigabyte. Now, when I built this system, I think I did this the way I wanted it, not the way it was defaulted. But let me get out of there before I mess around and mess up. Okay. This one it's not making sense to me the way they're doing this now. So that's a perfect example. Then. The other one, I don't know. There's another one that I, the older one, it's called Genome Disk. I know what it's called. So I need to go find it. I can't even go through everything on this because it's not making sense to me. Okay. I mean, the basic stuff right here, that still makes sense. Or does it? No, there's something missing. Where's the swap? Why is it not showing the swap? Oh, that's just an LVM view. Okay, that's me. LVM, this is not, if you look at the label, it's only showing you the LVMs. So if you get up here, SDD, wait. Yeah, SDD. Oh, that's the new one. SDA, okay, here we go, SDA. SDB is the one that's free space. Okay. Okay, I was turned around. So there's the 1024 megabyte, 1 gigabyte boot partition. See, it says boot right there. There's the LVM, which has the home directory and the root directories inside of the LVM. It used to be a regular ext3 or 4 partition, not inside an LVM. Okay, now, and then there's the swap. Okay, so it does show it right and everything. Good. I thought it was all messed up. So don't gripe so quickly, and then maybe you'll figure something out before you make a fool of yourself. Okay, so I'm going to put that up there. Let's see. You know what? I think that was the one. I kept seeing it, and I kept saying, no, that's not the one I'm looking for. Yeah, Genome, GTK, Genome Utilities, no. Genome Disk, it's in the middle. This is it, but it's not displaying it that way. So that's why I missed it. That is Genome Disk, and it is... One, the other one, I always like, I think I might have learned on Gparted first. But Genome Disk had some features that Gparted doesn't have. And there was, what was it? Some of the newer things that Fedora was coming out with. It was LVM2. For a while there, it couldn't, you could delete them, but you couldn't make an LVM2. You couldn't work with LVM2s. You could work with LVM1s, but not 2s. I don't know if you could ever actually make an LVM partition in Gparted. I only fooled with the LVMs when I was installing an operating system. But like, you know, if you're doing all kinds of other things, then you will maybe want to fool with them. So this one has got very tiny text, can't be read. That's one bad thing. Making it bigger, I don't think helps. Let's see. Nope, just makes a whole bunch of gray. That's why I decided to leave it like that. I'm finally beginning to learn you don't always want everything super big. So that one says it's 734 gigabyte, but the others say it 633 or something. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Now, that's something you'll have to get used to, because that's what happens with these disk programs, you know, disk management program. But, and this one, if you want to see the different things, you click on these. That's why I kept doing that. You click on these, or you won't see it in the down at the bottom there. The FSDA one, 1.1 gigabyte. See, the other one said it was 1024 megabytes, which it's a little bit more than that, I think. And then there is our SDA2. That's inside an LVM though, but that is the LVM. It's Dev SDA2. And then there's our swap partition. Okay, that's on the main set of six hard drives in the RAID 5. Okay, and this is the other single disk by itself that is nothing on it now. There's my new drive. This is the one that, though, I don't partition with this one because it gives errors. About half, 50-50, maybe less than 50-50 of being successful when you try to format things. But Gparted, if it says it can do it, it does it. If it says, if you run into an error, like I said, LVM2s that didn't used to be able to work with them, you know, you couldn't. So that's why sometimes I'd go back to this one. This one was the new one that was beta, but I think it's in full release now. This is Fedora 32. It doesn't say beta in there anywhere, so I think it was full release by then. But this is my new drive that I'm going to format. And I'm going through this because it's really kind of complicated, but there's some really cool GUI tools to work with it. And if you ask any, you know, sysadmin or whatever type person, they will always just tell you do this in the command line and do that. And you know how easy it would be to get that with all these SDBs and ones and twos? And it'd be so easy, even if you knew what you were doing, to screw that up. Me, I try to stay out of the command line. I know how to do things, but I can't remember commands. I have to copy and paste unless they're really short. In Fedora, I know if you know, like yum update or DNF update, you know, DNF space update and stuff like that. But anything that's more than, you know, six letters, it just escapes my mind. But my eyes swap letters and numbers, and so I can't even type what I'm trying to type. So I try to stay away from it. And if I do, I usually try to copy and paste. And it's getting worse over the years, you know. But anyway, that is, what is this? This is Ext4. gigabyte. Okay, LVM root. There you go. There's a view of what root looks like inside the LVM. This program shows you that. Okay, and then the other one is home. 591 gigabytes. So that's the actual spaces I have in each thing. And something I learned over the years, as much as I love to install programs, if you go with the default that Fedora gives you, which might be half of that, you'll fill up your root, and then your machine will will lock up or shut down or do something, and you won't really get any you're not going to get any. The first time it happened to me, it kept happening every once in a while. See, with the cache, when the cache gets deleted, it would go back to working. But when you fill up your cache, or if you did install the program, it would lock the operating system. So you need to have plenty of room in your root for what you're going to do, you know. Whether it's an LVM or if it was a regular ext3 or 4 partition. So I started customizing mine years ago. So anyway, this is one of the things I was wanting to show. This is the view of your partitions inside your LVM, your logical volume management. If you're familiar with servers, then you're used to seeing that. It's the same thing in RAID. Might be a word or two here that's used that's a little different, but especially from the way I'm talking, because I'm going in circles. But anyway, I'm going to get on the drive that I want to be working with. Okay, see, 12.73 terabytes is what it says it is in Blivit GUI. It just says 14 terabyte and 14 terabyte free in Genome Disk. And but it agrees, Gparted and Blivit. That they like Fedora encourages you to use Blivit and don't. I think I had to go find this and install it. It has some features that I don't think if Blivit has it, I don't know how you do it. And that's the other thing with the programs. You can't even tell what anything is. You can't see. There's some of the function of the program is right there. And, you know, I like to never found that. I think I had to read some instructions to find it. But power off this disk. Okay. I don't want to power it off, but I do want to release it because it's been mounted. I'm not going to do it with this, but here you go. There's the three dots. I'm not using a phone. I'm using a desktop. There's plenty of space for words up there, but they won't give them to you. Okay, format disk, create a disk image, or restore a disk image. Now, for a couple of years, Fedora, the way they were telling you to make your boot disk, you know, when you download your ISO, they had it all changed up. It was different than any other distro that I used, Bane and Fool. I used to love to test new ones, you know. I've still got a bunch of hundreds of ISOs, you know, on my drives. Anyway, you would do restore a disk image. Now, this is a cool feature, and I knew it always did work well. I always used other programs, Parted Magic, and that's a boot disk, but I can't think of the name of one I used. But there was one that I learned to use, and it was real dependable. If I wanted to make a disk image, I used that program. This was a Linux program, but it worked well with Windows. It worked well with Linux, file systems and everything. And this one I've never actually, I think I created an image once or twice just to see how it worked, but restore a disk image. Now, I don't think it'll even work now with the new Fedora ISO images, but back in around Fedora, either after Fedora 14, I'm going to say it was probably around Fedora 19 in that area, 16 to 19. That's how you had to do it. You download the ISO and then use restore a disk image and send it over to your CD, your DVD, or your USB stick. Benchmark disk. I did not realize that was in there. Huh. That would be a speed test. See, that's cool. So anyway, I wonder. No, I don't want to do that. There's no telling how long that would take to get any results out of it. Okay, so, but what I do want to do, I'm going to try, I think it'll be fine to leave this one on here, because if I leave it where it is, whether it's, I would expect that unallocated 1 megabyte, that's a standard thing for most file systems need that at the beginning. Actually, I don't think you need that for ext4, let's see. You know what? Let's look at my other ones. Yeah, see, there's no 1 gigabyte. One megabyte, I think it was. You don't need that in Linux. It's only for Windows where you really need that. But it doesn't always hurt. There are other instances where it's just 1 megabyte. When you're trying to, it's just a little. I can't even remember the reasons. There's several different reasons why that can be helpful with different programs. And well, with Windows, I think it can cause real trouble if you don't have it. But I'm going to leave it just to make sure it should be fine. I didn't pay attention when I had my 8 terabyte plugged in. I would like to know now if it's there or not, if I got rid of it or if it's there. I'm going to leave it. And sometimes it's better to, first you got to, I believe it's mounted. I'm going to right click. Yeah, you can see some. Okay, unmount. Now, when you have a Fedora, you can have a Fedora ext4. That's the one they're using now. An LVM. If an LVM can be you can unmount it or it can be unmounted, and it's still, you won't be able to work with it. And if you do it anyway, sometimes you can do it anyway, and you can break something and have to go back and fix it. So you always want to make sure that when you're going to format a disk, it never should be mounted, and it should never be, let's see if it can tell me the LVM. Okay, and I'm going to right-click. I have to be really careful. Deactivate. You've got to deactivate an LVM. Now, okay, now look at this. Unmount. See, that's the only option in there, unmount, when it's an EXT4 or 2, 3, or 4. But an LVM, you don't unmount it, you deactivate it. Okay, so, and I've forgotten it many times and messed up. Okay, this should not have anything, yeah, nothing you could do except for it's empty. It's unallocated, but you don't want to put anything on there. I'm going to say it kind of has, no, it's not caching. I don't remember. There are just certain file systems that just need, I'm not even going to try to say. I used to know it, but I can't, I'm running a blank here. Okay, so, but you know what? It shows it at the end instead of the beginning. It used to always be at the beginning. Huh. That may be why I think I had a feeling I got rid of it just to keep away, you know, not have confusion. What's that? You know, it's not. Well, I'm going to leave it at this point. I can. You can. Once I make this EXT4, as long as there's no data up in this end, at the that's the tail end, because this G part, it shows it in the order it really is in on the drive. I can just, you just drag that and stretch it, and it'll take up the rest of that. I have to delete that on. Actually, no, you wouldn't do anything. It's unallocated, so you can just stretch it, take that up. But I think I will leave it. It's only 1 megabyte. And I believe it's only really important to NTFS, but I can't remember for sure. So anyway, this is NTFS, you know, not an LVM, so you will unmount it. It's down there, it's kind of showing the progress. And those other programs, don't know if they update themselves, but they won't. Well, yeah, see, it's not mounted. See, it updated itself. It doesn't say whether it's mounted or not here. Oh, yeah, it's finished unmounting it, I think. Let's see. Yeah. See, now it doesn't. You can't mount it either. I'm kind of wondering why you can't, but that's fine. Name the partition elements. Well, sometimes when you're partitioning something, it's going to give it, it's going to erase whatever name you put in there, so I'm going to wait till after. Yeah, see, there's resize, move. You can copy a partition. Anyway. Information is very helpful in here. NTFS, 511 megabytes used. I saw that a while ago. The label is elements. I will probably change that label to sometimes, it depends. I'll probably just say 14 terabytes. Sometimes I have changed it to the actual size, but then when I realized different programs reported as different sizes, and it wasn't so much fun anymore. It made it kind of turn me in circles, and I'm like, what, you know? Yeah, I named it. Other one just 8 terabyte. For years, I kept fighting. I knew what it wasn't really that size, and I'd fight, you know, and I would name it. Well, you can't put a dot in a name anyway, in a label or a, I don't mess with the UID. The system does that automatically. The name, the label and the name, a lot of times they'll be different by default, but this one's both exactly the same. But anyway, like I said, the label, I can't remember what will happen. We'll see. The name is, I know for sure you can make that pretty much what you want, as long as you don't put like periods and things in there that it won't accept. MSFT data. Okay, so that's what it, there's the, what was that, the flags? Information. There's information, and then there's flags. There's no flags showing up in here. But yeah, see, you could change the UUID. You could label the file system. You could check it. It works, but you got to watch out because I've seen it before in the past where it just automatically tried to fix it and it actually broke it because it wasn't. I think it might have been a Windows file system because this is a Linux program and it does work with Windows file systems. Anyway, I just remember it causing trouble, so I kind of got leery of using that check. Oh, if you're mounted or if it's an LVM and you didn't release it, that's where you get into trouble, I think. Okay, and I did that. Okay, format two. Now, at the top of the choice is BTRFS. I still can't remember. I don't know if Windows can read that one. I don't think so, really. It's kind of like a software RAID. It backs its own self up, but it really takes a chunk. And I'm not sure, like, if older Linux systems would be able to read it, so I'm going to stick with ext4. Yeah, see, oh, and xfat, you can't use that one. That, I think, is the one that, I don't know if it's xfat or, no, I think it's xfs that most of your flash media comes with. It's a Windows file system. But anyway, I'm going to go with ext4. Let's just select it now. But let's go back in there just to kind of finish looking at them. So I don't know what some of those are. Linux swap, LVM2PV, that's what I was just talking about a lot. Minix. You know, I think that was a copy of Linux. Yeah, I mean, it really would be just another version of Linux, but they use their own file system. I'm not sure what that is. NTFS, where's FAT32? Yeah, there it is. FAT16, that was like for Windows 3.1 before. Then FAT32, I guess it kind of basically come out around Windows 95. I don't remember HFS. NTFS, that's what we're getting away from, but you can format NTFS with this. XFS, it's either XFS or XFAT. I think it is XFS now, is now what they put on the SD cards. And but if you're going to, I usually end up putting FAT32 on my SD cards and USB sticks because it'll work well in Linux and Windows. And I clear it. You can just, that's how you would get rid of the formatting if it's already formatted. So I'm not going to say do anything this time. And now up here you can have other menus. Sometimes it's easier for me to apply all operations, clear, undo. It's easier for me to create a partition table. It's already got one because it's NTFS, but I think it's going to get a partition table. If it doesn't, I'll have to check and see. If it doesn't have one, you have to do it right there. But I believe when you just do the your drive wouldn't, if you were putting an operating system on it, well, it wouldn't even be read if it didn't have a partition table. So I don't believe, and there is an attempt data rescue. I've never used it. I think I might have played with it, but I've never used it. I've just always used test disk. I learned it long before I learned departed. And it's much really powerful. Okay, so trying to get that where I could read that. So there's not much in there right now. And then here is apply all operations. That's what I usually do, is click that check because I always remember that. So I'm going to say apply all operations. Are you sure you want to apply the pending operations? Editing partition says the potential to cause data loss of data. You are advised to back up your data before proceeding. Yes, do not do this if you have data on there that you want. Make sure you're on the right drive because you can run your operating system. 1230 73 gigabyte dev SDD, and of course that's the biggest drive. I've never had a drive that big, so I know that's the right drive. So I'm going to hit apply, and it will sit there and do that for a while. and I'm about to die here. I'm going to have a break. So all I know to do is take the break, and I'll be back in a minute. Let's see. I got to make sure what mic I'm on, though. Okay, yeah, that's fine. I'll just leave it. You may hear some background noise. But I'll be back in a minute, and it should be done when I get back. It may be done before I get up. I'm back, and it looks like it's done, but let me get my glasses on. Sure, the mic and everything looks good. Let's get over here on the OBS studio area desktop. Okay, yeah, we still got sound. We're on desktop. Okay, sometimes I forget and I'm on a camera or vice versa, you know, when I want to be one place, I'm on another. All right, so formatted Ext4. Calibrate, check. Clear old file system, check. Yeah, so you don't have to delete it first. You can just do it that way. Seems like there were times when I had trouble doing that. It might have just been the older version of Gparted. Or I forgot to deactivate it or unmount it, most more likely. Okay, we got our AXT, and you can save the details of that report is what that means. And I don't need that. Everything worked perfectly. See, it will, it's just updating the program. So, yeah, I'm just going to leave that little 1 megabyte at the end. I've forgotten when you would need it and when you wouldn't. But I think it's really to do with Windows, and I'm not going to, you know, have Windows on here. I've done a lot of, I used to do dual boot, so every time I built a system, I would have Windows, and it has to be at the beginning because Windows can't read past 32 gigabytes or 32 gigabytes, I think, or something. But anyway, and then you could partition it up and put Linux starting anywhere you want. I'd usually give a little bit smaller partition for Windows because I didn't use it much. Just a few programs I used to like to use or play with, but I don't even care anymore because every Windows system I had one time got a network virus and they all got infected. And I ended up just reformatting everything, except for that laptop still has XP on it, the one that the server's on, my web server, and then half is XP and half is the Bane Linux. Didn't need but, you know, about 3 gigabytes really for my website. You know, the data's like 1.5-2 gigabytes in the operating system. Anyway, and it's messed up. Well, I know it had viruses when I first got it. My niece gave it to me, but I think I reformatted it, or did I just keep cleaning it until it showed no more trouble? I can't remember. But anyway, something really wrong with it. It's got to be malware. I think I've scanned it several times and it doesn't show any. But they could have been cleaning it. Might have broke, you know, deleted some files that just needed. Runs, but it runs so slow you can't use it. And it used to run really fast when I first got it. After I cleaned it up, I mean. Its NTFS file system was broken. It took me 5 minutes to fix that with test disk. And it took me 3 days to a week to clean it up. It was running every virus scanner. You can't just run one or three. You've got to keep running about different virus. Best thing to do is run different free open source virus scanner rescue systems until they one time I did a system and it took 10 different scanners, 10 different rescue ISOs, you know, to boot up to finally get it to quit saying it had viruses. But still, you know, it's an ongoing battle. They always figure out ways to hide them. They're still out there and they still do it, but they would hide them in the MBR, the master boot record. And then as soon as you rebooted, they would just put themselves back. Or they'd have downloaders, you know, that would they don't have to have much data. They can just something that tells it to download the malware and then it puts itself back on there. My throat's. It's going bad again. I'm sitting here under that fan. It's 80.2, but luckily Oh, well, no, it's 4:34, so it's fixing to be the hardest part of the day. It's always, well, I guess it would really be the hottest part at 4 now because the sun's going down way earlier. 5 in the summer is usually the hottest part of the day. 3 to 5, usually 5 is really the hottest. I'm going to give me another cough drop. I keep seeing myself at my cameras. I can see that preview. I think I'm on it, but I'm not. That's sometimes I turn it around so it won't fool me, but I got it turned where I can see it, but I'm not. You don't want to do that. You don't want to look at that. You want to look at the OBS preview so you know what you're really showing. Okay, that's weird. It says used 1.92 gigabyte. Why would it be using that much gigabyte? I guess I just forgot that. MSTF data is what it's called. Now you have to. Well, now maybe with a USB drive you might not have to, but I know with any regular hard drive you've got to reset. So if it's a regular hard drive in the system, you need to reboot. Yeah, with the USB sticks and everything, sometimes. And the SD cards, I think maybe, sometimes you could get away with not unplugging them and plugging them back in, reset the drive, shutting them down and turning them back on. Sometimes you can't. It might have been, it's always safer to do that though, but, you know, like I said, I always put FAT32 on them, and that's a Windows file system, so. And the Ext4, it may not matter, but I'm going to go ahead and do that for safety. But let's look at what we got. Information. I don't know why it says 192 used. Well, it didn't change what's left, so that must be how they present you with that fake space, you know, the 14 terabytes. Yep, 12, 13, 14. So, it's not mounted, see, so you couldn't write to it right now. Now, I could go and mount it, but I'm just going to unplug it, plug it back in, it should mount itself. Another way to know whether it worked right. The name, elements, flags, MSTF data. I hate where you can't even read all that. It's not something you can make bigger. Okay. What else? there's no label on the file system now. And you can change the name just fine, and I think I will do that. But I'm not going to mess with labeling the file system. Sometimes that's no problem. Sometimes it actually have to have been done in the right sequence or you'll jack it up. It, what did it say its label was? I thought it said what its label was. Label, file system, ext4. Yeah, see, I don't want to mess with that. I don't think you want to do that. I think that would really, no, that's not the label. The label's right here. Okay, that's right above the long number. It just says unused right there. Okay, maybe it would have been right here. I'm not sure. I'm going to leave it unless I find a need for it. I remember that the name, you can fool around with it as much as you want, but the label, sometimes it'll jack you up. I don't know if it does. Again, I don't know if it only does that in Windows or file systems or in Linux, too. I can't remember. You can check it. I'm not going to do that. Manage flags. Okay, it's labeled as a data drive. That's what that is. Okay, yeah. You know, if you want to boot to it, you need to go ahead and give it a boot label, but I'm not going to boot to that. So that's important, actually, and the default is what I'm going to leave it on. It saw that it was a data drive, I guess. And it did it right. I'm about to cough again. Hang on. Sound like an elephant. Okay. Now, started draining and everything again. I don't know if a cough drop helps my throat, but I'm not so sure it doesn't actually cause my nose to start running. did the last time, too. All ago. Forgot the last temperature call out I gave, but it's 80.2 in here now, and it's 81 outside, but that is in Fort Worth, and I'm about 15 miles from, or 12, something. Okay, so, it's usually warmer up in town than it is out here. Name the partition. Yeah, it's elements. I'm going to call it 14 terabyte. You can't put a dash in there. I think you can put an underscore, but that's just confusing because it usually just shows up as a space. I don't think you can put a space in there. So I'm going to name it 14 terabyte. That way I'll know for sure which drive it is every time I see it. I see elements up there, and I'll go, what? I mean, if it said West WD or Western Digital, I could call it 14 TB WD. I want to leave it like that because WD doesn't, it reminds me of like WB TV network, and it doesn't click with me as a computer thing. So Warner Brothers TV network, one of the channels we have here. I'm sure they're all over the country, all over the world by now. Okay. So that is all I want to do with it. I'm going to, like I said, turn it off and turn it back on, reset it. Let's see if it changed up here in these other programs. It's not mounted, but I don't want to mount it. Like I said, you could, but when you're doing a format like that, you want to go ahead and reset it. It still says NTFS. Maybe if you go off of it and go back on it or something, it might change. No, it didn't. I'm just going to leave those programs open and see what happens, because I usually don't have them open like that. Now, that one did. I clicked off of it. Actually, I forgot to really look and see what it said right there. But anyway, it's showing it right. And this is the old one. See, that's the newer one. Doesn't do that. Maybe if I go on a completely different disk or something. Still says it's the NTFS. So see, that's a confusing thing. Would make it. You might think it didn't work or something. You know, if you're using that one and it didn't up, it might update if I'd use that program. But I like to look at. I will look at Genome Disk and Gparted just so, you know, I'm making sure I'm double checking everything and getting things right. So, now, Let's get over here to the camera. Excuse me. Now I'm starting to try to hiccup.
And, okay, make sure my mic's working. Now, see if I can bring it over in front. I was going to try and, yeah, I think I can get it up here. That's all I wanted to do. I was going to move the camera. I thought, man, that's going to be a pain. So I'm not going to unplug the USB. That would just, you know, unplug the data connection. I'm going to unplug the power. That's what you do to reset any drive, but with the, you know, there is a power switch right there. I forgot to get off the desktop. Dang it. Let's get back over here. Okay, so what I did, it hasn't come back up yet. What I did was unplug this, the power, the round barrel connector, but there is a power switch. I might need to use that. Let's go back and see if it's... I'm switching off of it and switching back on. There. Yeah, see, now it's updated. Okay, this is getting heavy. This is a heavy drive. But the power switch, we'd like to know how it works. I might do that. I might turn it off and turn it back on. Well, first, I want to see how unplugging it did. Did it change its position? What happened? That's 107. 147, 70. Oh, it's not in there anymore. Once I moved off of it, it refreshed it away to nothing. I was looking to see if there was like a reload or something. I don't see anything about reloading. Oh, there's where you could do the... Oh, that's the same thing. Some of the same stuff is over there in the left side. I might click on that benchmark disk just to see what it does after I'm done with what I'm going to get done. That still says NTFS. I guess I'm going to end up having to close that one and open it back up to get it. I don't think I really need it for anything now, though. This one is showing it like it should. So... kind of curious to me why it says MSFT data. That would make me think of Microsoft when it's an ext4 Linux partition. You know, NTFS didn't used to be able to make a, from what I remember, didn't used to be able to make a partition 14 terabyte. They might have changed it, they might have updated it. I haven't used it in years, other than on that Seagate drive. But let me get on the camera this time. And yeah, there's a switch. If I can get it in the view. It's the light. It's making it not show up. Is it lack of it or whatever? It's right there, it's the same color. Can't even feel it. There. I don't think it went on or off. I'm not gonna do it again. Let's see if anything happened. You might have to hold it down a little longer. I guess I should learn about it. Let's get back over here on the desktop and see if anything changed in our programs. Doesn't look to me like it did anything at all. Maybe I didn't hold, I know I pressed it, but maybe I didn't press it long enough. Okay, let's get, this time we'll do desktop and four, so maybe we can tell what's going on. Okay, we'll get over here. And if anything happens in these programs, I'll be able to see it. Okay, the one that I gotta watch out for is getting wonky. Okay, now there's a button up at, right up in there. I'm looking at the little light while I'm doing this. So I'm gonna hold it down for, you know, there it goes. Okay, you gotta hold it down for probably 15 seconds. Now it's off. There's a little white light in the front. I'm not gonna try to turn it that far around. But it went off. I'm gonna set it down again. Now this one I know will tell you whether it's there or, you know, doesn't refresh automatically. It looks like it's still there. Back to a different one again. Since there's nothing, I don't know, I was thinking since there's nothing on that drive, I picked that other drive. This one has not showed it anymore. I don't see a reload button in here, so I would have to, now that's still on that one. That's the one that, don't have anything on. So the wording in there is confusing. See, that doesn't do anything, but that does. Yeah, those darker ones are just labels. They're all labels, so why do they do that? Okay. So, I went and wrote a file to it. Oh, I got to turn it back on, don't I? Because I know it's off. So, well, let's go see if it shows up in the... I might turn it back on, but let's see. Yeah. Let's go ahead and get back on the desktop. Now, let's see if I open up... Crusader is set. I have it set to automatically mount file system, so if it can see it. Okay, see, Elements is no longer a good name. Can't even go back. It's in something that doesn't exist. Okay. Okay, so no, it's not mounted. And it's not even going back to where the, well, the 8 terabyte's gone too, so it won't go back there. Okay, let's see if I can remember how to get there. Go to the root of the whole system, and then go to, I think it's run. User? Nope, that's not it. It's so crazy how they changed it. I don't go to it this way very often because usually you just click on the button up there. I'm trying to scan all those words to see if I see one that reminds me. Var is where your server stuff would be. I think. No, that's not where it is. That's the other thing. The bank puts some, you know, like your website, where you put your websites, if you have a web server. I don't have a web server installed, but the folders are still there. A media, that's not where things mount, and that is where your CD drive used to mount. And, well, everything could be mounted there. Yeah, media. But no, you'll never see it there in Fedora for quite a few years now. And, yeah, I just wasn't paying FTP, pub, That's where you put your FTP. Now, I'm not running the server on here. I don't think it's even installed, but I'm not running it. But if you're going to do an FTP server, and then www is where your website would be. I used to, my older machine, I had Apache set up on it just to test my websites and stuff before I put them on my actual web server. But, so that's not it. I think it is run media. There you go. Now, if that was not there, see, it's an error because, but it was mounted. Now, this is one of those things that I could have a headache now. Let's see if we can get out of there. I think as long as I'm in there, it's going to do that. Yep. Dang it, that pissed me off. Can't do it fast enough to get. I'm trying to hit the back button while that's gone. None of that will work as long as that's up there. I'll try closing the program, but I don't think you can't close the program. Now, that is a bug. I'd forgotten all about that. But I do believe I ran into that before. Let's see, how can I get out of it? You can keep clicking and clicking and clicking, and it won't get you out of there. Oh, I'll try doing like same. See, you can't do that. Doesn't help. See, you only got one mouse, so you can't click. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do then. This is why I keep this open all the time. Crusader. There it is. File so. Let's try ending that process. That's part of Crusader. I don't think it'll work. Okay, then. Oh, it did. Let's see if they can put it back to normal. Nope, it did not. We're going to go ahead and end Crusader. You know what? I don't know if there's any other way to get out of that. Okay, now that's gone. Okay. Now they've got Crusader shut down. I should be able to. It always goes back to where you left off. It's the problem. Okay, it's okay now. It's just saying it's not there. That's weird. Okay, so, but it's not mounted or it would show up right there. So you got that's the area for different drives and that's the area for your different folders. So, I forgot. You can't mount it. Okay, yeah, so it's not turned on, I don't think. Well, I knew that. I turned it off. I'm trying to see what the operating system shows us to when that button's turned off. Those didn't matter anyway. When you see it. What was it I was going to try to do? Oh, I wanted to go to... I forgot. See if that 8 terabyte drive would have been... would have been there. Now run media, and if I click on Don, it'll leave me that way again because I don't have that 8 terabyte drive plugged in. I don't want it plugged in yet. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do for desktop again, and there's a hole next to that. I'm wondering what it is. See it. I don't know. It's dark in there. There's a hole to my right. It'd be to the right of the cables. I don't know what it's for. Okay, now there's our button. Can't even hardly feel it. Okay, you don't have to mash it very long to put it back on. Now you've got your little white light. I'm glad it's not some big obnoxious light. You know, everything they made for 10 years is so obnoxious you couldn't stand to have it in the room. And I've got my, you know, I've got this stuff in my room where I sleep and everything. And, okay, now let's go see. Oh, the whole reason I was doing desktop was so that I could have this on screen. Let's see. Let's go ahead and get off the camera now. You gotta be smart to use this fancy screen views. Okay, it's not mounted though. So turning it off and turning it back on didn't mount it. Yeah, it's not over there on the left. Sometimes it just takes a while to mount. Once in a while it'll do that. Especially when you're fiddling with them, turn them on and turn them off. But, I can see it's not mounted because there's no icon over here. Oh, you know what? Why it doesn't have an icon? Because I deleted the file that has the icon. So that'd be one of the first things I wanted to put it back. I don't think I'll put... Let's go try this again. Try to get myself in a situation to where I could show what it is I'm doing on the desktop and the machine. It is a machine, but yeah, I have to stay like that. So yeah, I have to use the screen on the to do that on the camera itself. Okay, so I'm going to unplug it. Doesn't go away in this one or anything, but I think it will still update once I plug it back in. I'll be able to get it to work. And the light's on, it happens pretty fast. So let's see, I may end up having it whacking it out to where I have to reboot the server to get it to ever see it again. I hope not. That's something you need to know, you need to learn about. Oh, it mounted itself. So that's the best thing to do, is unplug it and then plug it back in. And see, there's nothing on it but the lost and found that was, I think Linux puts that in there for Aura. I don't like this file manager, so. It still doesn't show. It is mounted. Okay, yeah. Mount's not available because it's already mounted. But. So, and that's all going to be the same. Yeah. I don't know that that will. Yeah, it's not good. There's nothing for it to change. That's what it should say. So I think this is actually doing what it should do. This one here. Oh, there's 14 terabytes. So it showed up and now you can see it. Okay. Because I was on that 107 gigabyte drive with nothing on it when it erased. Okay. Good deal. Now you can see it's DevSDC in there. Oh, look at that. That's something I didn't know happened. It says it's Dev SDC 1. That's, oh, yeah, that's the only 14 terabyte in there. I don't think you can make this. Yeah, you can't make that. That needs to be wider. But that doesn't help. So you're not going to be able to read that no matter what. I can't stand the fixed width on that. It should always, you know, size to the text and let you read it all, is what it should do. And if you need to make it smaller, allow you to make it smaller, and maybe you'll have to lose some of it. It can just always go around, you know, wrap around, just like a spreadsheet. You could just have it size to the text and then wrap around it maybe at some point if it, you know, gonna go well. Used to, it would, like, if it was wider than the screen, it would wrap around. And this is all the way back to, I don't remember Windows 3.1. I started with Windows 3.1, but Windows 98 did. And then Linux always used to. Go all the way from Fedora 5. Okay, now what are we on up here? That one still says NTFS. Let's see if we can go off of it, go back and see if it will change. Nope, it still says it's elements. So blue, it's not very good, not good at refreshing. that's free space. I don't want it. None of those are. I got to thinking maybe I just need to refresh it. Reload storage. That one has a button for reload storage. Now maybe it'll work. SDC1. Ext4. Now it's right. Okay, so that's what you got to do and live it. And this one, all you had to do is just when you, it just did it when you restarted, restarted the drive. This one's kind of the same way. There might be a refresh in there. I generally, you don't really need it because you know what you, you're usually going to, I mean, well, it is a pain to shut the program and open it back up and all that stuff. That will do it for sure if you shut. But sometimes, here's a word, Tumblr can be a pain. I don't remember what caused it. Somebody told me that I was having trouble. I don't remember what it was, but the when I would open it, when I opened my favorite one, Gparted, it would scan for 10, 20 minutes before it would find just to be, you know, the, which normally it would just be 30 seconds, you know, or maybe a minute to scan all the drives and get, see what they were. And I don't remember, but the person that told me, they're an expert in that kind of stuff. And I think it was Adrian, the developer of Rescue Touch, or Resca Touch is what it's actually supposed to be called. It's a rescue system for rescuing systems, working with file systems and everything like that. But you boot to it, you know, you don't install it on your operating system. And it runs on the Bang. He was talking about making a Fedora version, but he's always worked in the Bang. I don't know exactly what he does as his job, but I'm sure he's some kind of sysadmin or something, a boss in the IT department or something. He lives in Spain, but pretty cool guy. He helped me out a lot. I just made a video. I was trying to use it, and I was making a video, and I was like, oh man, it was all outdated and it wasn't working anymore, and I thought, dang it. And then he came in the next time I was making a live video and started talking to me and commented. And liked it, didn't. I can't keep up with all that. I don't try. I think I turned it off. I finally think I just turned off the comments because it just, you know, people come and try to comment and then it's kind of insulting for me not to answer them. They don't understand. And so finally I turned it off one other time and then I turned it back on and I think I just turned it off again not too long ago. But you have to have your browser open and everything, and that, well, my machine couldn't do it, my old machine. This one can do it, but I've got more than I can keep up with just trying to make a video and do the stuff I'm doing. So, okay. What are we on? Okay, we're on the double view. Okay, I'm going to get back on the desktop. Yeah, see, like I forgot that's how it was. Sometimes that actually matters. Let's see, it should be in there now. Okay, now, don't click on the 8 terabyte USB because it's actually not there. It gave it that set of numbers instead of its regular name, but there it is. That's what will happen. Maybe I needed to give it a, I think that's not the UUID, but anyway, that's basically a random number. I think it might be different every time. Yeah, see, I got it to say 8 terabyte USB. I don't remember. Used to, when they used just the folder media, you could just make a folder in there with what name you want it to be, and if it was there, it was there, and if it wasn't, it wasn't. But it wouldn't give it wouldn't lock you up like that. You know? I don't think you can just make a folder in there anymore. I don't remember. There it is. Okay, so here's what I wanted to do. Here's my downloads, the folder I made. Now, that's program and that's a program. System volume information. Let's kind of look and see. I want to view it. I don't think that's going to, yeah, that's, I don't think I want that on there for ext4. I think that would only work for Windows. I don't want any of that on there. but there should be an icon. Let's make one the same. I think I could get by. Well, it's just a... I'm not used to it not being there. Now I won't be able to get out of it again. Oh, wait. No, I won't be able to get out of there. I was going to say, okay, I'll copy my icon. I'm going to have to do this again. Kill it again. This time I'm just going to shut down Crusader because I think the file so will go away on it along with it. Let's see. Yeah, it's going away first. Okay, good. That's the simplest thing to do, and that's why I leave that open all the time, that system manager. I like this one because you can search in it to find your program real quick and easy. I didn't even break it. Okay, I have an icon that I had to manually put on my Seagate drive so that it would show an icon instead of just, but I'll have to do that later. It's got one, but it's, can't see it very good. But it says 14 terabyte volume. That's what you need. That'll be a quick difference. It's just my background is making enough. So, surprise, surprise, I think I'm finally done. I need to have another break and there's no point in me going and leaving it running. So I'm just gonna end the stream here. That's what I really wanted to do today. And I'm not gonna try to get into the other 146 hard drive, gigabyte hard drives and stuff. I'll have to do that in its own video. That's probably the best thing to do anyway. All right, well, see you later.